Okay. From beginning. Yep. Left button works as a click. So left click.
Okay. Should I go introduce you to myself? Mm-hmm. Hi, I'm Nicole Wynn. Should I introduce
judge
myself
number two.
To them too? Oh.
Mm-hmm. Judge number three.
Okay, for my senior project, the left one is next?
Yes.
Okay, I created a commercial for the Georgia Master Gardeners. And you may be wondering who the Georgia Master Gardeners are. And they are a volunteer organization who go around and do different community service projects for senior centers, and they also started...
Thank you. Right.
And they also started a Junior Master Gardeners Association, and I've been to the one that's at Boston. And they did a really good job there. There's lots of different fruits and vegetables they have growing there, and the kids get to go and pick them and eat them, and they teach them all about gardening. And they donate a lot of time and energy and money into helping making the community look like a better place. I chose this topic because this is my project facilitator. His name is Greg Padgett, and this is Dot Martin, and they are Georgia Master Gardeners, and they came into my video broadcasting class asking if anyone would be interested in making a commercial for their conference, and I said that I would love to if I got to use it for my senior project. So it's kind of a win-win situation. They got a free video, and I got to use it for my senior project. My research paper relates to my project because all of my research paper was about advertising and what is the best form of advertisement and how you need to sell yourself to your customer, and all about product placement and the best way to come across to your target audience. What was the purpose for making this commercial? It was to support the Master Gardeners and also to inform people, because I know I've never heard about them before they came in and talked to us. And I don't think a lot of young people know about it, and that's one of the reasons why they started the Junior Master Gardeners Association, so that they could really get their organization out there so that they could do even more community service. And also to motivate people. The conference that I made this video for is actually this Saturday, and I'm getting like recognized there for making the video. And it's just to, you know, keep people motivated to keep doing a good job and making the community look like a better place. Some of the problems that I encountered when I was making my video was I took hours and hours and hours of footage and had to make it into a 6-minute video, and that was this is the first video that I made that was that lengthy. Usually for class it's like 3 to 4 minutes at the most, and this was like my first professional video where I had interviewing and I really had to worry about the audio levels. I had never really focused on the audio before. It was just kind of whatever the camera did is what we went with, but with the interviewing, we have a lavalier, which you can see on this picture, is just one of the mics that attaches to like a tie or a shirt, and it makes it a lot clearer and a lot better for you to understand what the person you're interviewing is saying. And it has a lot of cables and a lot of different things that you have to connect into the video camera, and it was my first time ever using one of those. And I messed up a couple of times on it, and we had to go and redo the interview again because the audio was a little screwy at some points. So I learned a lot from this experience, even though, and I was really happy with my product, but there were still things that I would have liked to change even more. But I learned an incredible amount from this product, this project, and it was a lot of fun to do. And this is me interviewing the mayor of Canton, which was my first interview that I did for the video, and so that was a little intimidating, but it was a lot of fun, and he was really nice. I plan on using this towards my future career because I want to be a missionary and go to foreign places and do mission work and take videos and then bring them back to the United States. And this is my first trip to Guatemala that I took over the December break. And I actually made a video when I was there. Well, like, took all the video footage when I was there and then came back and edited it all. And now it's on YouTube. But I learned a lot of things through my senior project that made me more ready to make an even better video. So this was really an awesome experience to be able to have, like, Mr. Padgett, who is, he graduated with a video broadcasting degree, and Ms. Younger there to help me through the whole thing and to really teach me firsthand how to make videos better than I ever have before. So now I was just going to show you like 2 minutes of the video, I guess, depending on how much time I have.
The video comes in at, you're probably at just under 2 minutes. So just under 2 minutes of the, and you get the 8 minute
one. Okay.
Sorry, now you're like at in that six-ish land when you started.
Okay.
That's even with the door happening. So you're probably in a good place to maybe do three or four minutes of video.
Okay.
The way to get out of here is right click. And from here you can use the thumb or you can go over and click screen, whichever one you want to do.
Click and show?
No, screen.
Oh.
And then switch programs. And now you got the bar at the bottom. And again, you can go over and click, or you can just click or, yep, thumb yourself over to video and play in the bottom left or right there.
The Gardner's Circle of Life will highlight the Native American influence still present today across Cherokee County, a growing North Georgia community with ties to agriculture, history, and horticulture.
Really at the foothills of the Blue Ridge Mountains, and the slogan of our chamber, of course, is where Metro meets the mountains.
Cherokee County is named after the Cherokee Indian Nation, which inspires this region still today. From their culture, community landmarks, and heritage, many of the county's schools, neighborhoods, festivals, and businesses reflect this American Native influence.
The neat thing about coming here is the history. I love plants. I'm an admitted plantaholic, but I also love people and I love history. And so with the Gardner's Circle of Life and the Cherokee Indians here, I think it's a perfect time for people to get together, talk about the history of plants and how they've affected people through the years.
The conference will be hosted by the local chapter of the Georgia Master Gardeners in Cherokee County, a very active chapter with a heavy influence in the local community. From hosting educational programs like plant clinics and plant sales, to sponsoring a community garden at the local senior center, and supporting many other programs throughout the year.
Cherokee County Master Gardeners, I think, have a great program that we do to educate people in Cherokee County about horticulture, how to take care of their yards and plants, and how to deal with the bugs and diseases, and just support the extension office.
We're very fortunate Cherokee County have a very active Master Gardener program at the junior level. Junior Master Gardeners, in fact, here at Oak Grove, we're growing peppers, tomatoes, we have watermelon and cantaloupe, and really the kids are learning a lot about gardening. They're also applying it to their curriculum.
Well, there are all kinds of good things that they're growing out here.
The Junior Master Gardener program is just one example of the chapter's outreach
right
efforts.
Now
it's helping to educate the next wave of future gardeners.
9 minutes in.
2012 conference will provide many opportunities for attendees to learn more about Junior Master Gardening and other programs sponsored by the University of Georgia's Extension Service. This year's conference offers attendees the opportunity to attend breakout sessions with horticultural experts, tour a museum of Native American artifacts, see thousands of trees at the Restored Arboretum, and visit the newly opened Breathtaking Gifts Garden. Call Georgia's hidden jewel, this magnificent 300-acre estate.
It's got 2 minutes and 41.
Yeah. Because we've seen the interview, we've seen some of the editing, we've seen the enough of the commercial that you brought in from your presentation thus far. So maybe at this point, what you could do is, how easy is it to do from here, is if you...
20 acres of gardens,
but just mute it, and then thank the judges for their time, and ask if they have any questions while the commercial still runs behind you, so you get this. That might be a way just to to give them something to ask questions about one.
Okay.
And you can ask them, and then they're like, "Oh no, we want to watch it." Then you know, is this coming back over here and clicking the sound back on and continuing? Judges, questions?
What did you learn from doing this product? Like, how did it change?
How
you were before?
I just learned a lot about everything. Like, I'd never done anything to this extent before. And it was all me. Like, I didn't have anyone else doing any other part of the video. So if I didn't know how to do something, I learned how to do it.
I think you want to establish through the learning stretch is just establish what the extent is, having come from the class, because they're going to know that you were in the class. So, and you mentioned we'd only done 3 minutes or so before, so it's just not its volume, but it's the design, it's the audio, it's all of the decision making.
Right.
And be a little bit more, all the decisions made here were decisions that I made to try and sell it the best. And you're going to mention what? That you won.
Oh. Yeah, I don't even know the name of it. I have it in my portfolio.
Well, again, let's bring it up here as either the attention grabber or wherever you want to use it, but you won an award for this. And then this Saturday, if there's a picture of them handing you a certificate, if they give you a certificate, if they give you whatever, if they give you a plant, try and keep that thing alive for 2 weeks and bring it in as part of your presentation. But nicely done. Thank you. That should be the first line we see, is your newspaper. Make that part of the, dress it up. Be proud of yourself. Nobody else, there's one other student I have, maybe two in the whole senior class that actually had a newsworthy made local press made up in a paper for the project. So, celebrate. Yes, in the box. Thank you, ma'am. Do you feel better?
Yeah. Done? I mean, I wasn't really hearing anything.
So there's that for you. There's that for me.
Did I hear you?
You might have.
Might not have.
It was clear. Put it underneath. For that very reason. Do you want a hard case? I might have one.
I have one on you.
If you want to go look in the office in this back left hand corner, there might be some, or actually in the back left hand or the back right hand corner, there might be some jewel cases. Thank you, judges, for judging and staying and giving her a sense of audience.
Do you want to click through mine real quick?
You go first. You look through hers.
Okay. Oh, is this too?
No, you gotta go up there and you gotta get up.
What were you checking on yours?
Yeah.
We need to check that back.
Yeah. No.
Because I know what you did, but if it makes sense for her, that's more than that.
Thanks for letting me.
No. Do you need a pass to get to four?
I'm just going to lunch.
Okay, just write something and I'll find it.
Okay.
That's my brother, my father, and my grandfather. But he's the deputy sheriff of Putnam County, and he's the sheriff of Putnam County. And the rest of the guys are just like friends. Well, friends with them, because we are the sheriffs too.
Cool.
Can I open the paper? And then it'll just look my paper once I can get on the side of everything. Itself. And then, because I'll figure, I'll just be like thumbing through
back to the time.
What you mean,
yeah. Already played it before and play it now.
Yeah, I think that I used the board and it was annoying to turn around and click it.
Yeah,
because it makes it super annoying to click it.
No, not really.
Okay, licenses.
So,
we're going to hear and talk about like what each point means.
That one was the same.
I might change the font on the last one because that like hurt my eyes a lot. I don't know if that would hurt anyone else's.
The color?
Yeah. Okay. Like, well, not the, that's what I meant, the color. Like, okay. Maybe like a deep red, like a maroony, so that it would kind of stand out, but it would be more of like silence.
Okay.
Yeah. So, what I'll do, yeah,
and
I'll
then
do,
I haven't
I'll
done
it
anything
up
on the side of the apartment yet.
Yeah. And then what we're going to end up doing
is the second part of my.
No, I'm just going to leave.
Can you, like, read this open?
Oh, yeah.
And
if you explain it, like, they'll know.
And all we're going to do is we're going to insert.
And I'm going to have a few of the
hyperlinks.
And now it's going to zoom in on each one.
Hyperlinks don't set
that
yet. Or
is it
site
machine?
Yeah, I'm going to point somewhere. I'm going to have to go point to that project.
Videos.
And if it presents.
And then this is everything I needed in each one.
Current. Because you've already opened it in the background, when you click on it,
can you like clearly read that?
It's pulling up
like,
the video.
It's going to come back so
it is.
That's my actual hunting license.
That should pull the video from the beginning.
Mm-hmm.
And
then,
so the reason that
so far
works is because we already had it loaded. You could be the first person to use video in that room.
Mm-hmm.
So I just go ahead and open up Windows Media Player.
So
up
my picture's
files.
Okay, maybe don't seem like too grainy.
It wasn't all your
I have like
packages.
Six videos, but I have like a minute, if that.
Okay.
So am I going to have to retype that?
Yeah, and then just retype it. Or two and then just highlight it.
Like, I thought I would have, like, go through everything really fast. My 8-minute mark would be happening. So I was like, wow. And I had a 2-minute video. So I was like, oh my gosh.
Well, no, I don't even think some of them are even, a minute, because it's like, I only took video, because my brother made, like, our cool video, like, our family and stuff, of our trip, and so I just took the clips that I was in, and that was it. So it was just kind of like, you see me shoot here, you see me stand here, you know, so it's nothing like, you have to, like, sit there and tell me to watch, because I can be, like, talking through it while they're playing.
So
that's the next one.
That's just slide up.
Yeah.
Okay. Obviously, just like the top.
And let's see what's
So, thank you, man.